Now we need to figure out how to use computed observables to add functionality to our application, specifically to add a cat name feature and a cat title feature. In order to learn how to use them, we'll take a look at the documentation together. Now, first off, every library and framework has its own documentation, and libraries without documentation are not very effective to use. So, if documentation is missing or especially poor, nobody will want to use the library, and it won't take off. Chances are, if you've heard of a library before, it probably has pretty good documentation. Now, Knockout's documentation is actually more of a series of articles here, rather than a traditional documentation set. That's okay though, because most of the information we need is here. If you find the documentation lacking, there's probably a blog post by someone else illuminating the thing you're looking for. And to figure that part out, I usually start with a Google search. Now let's take a look at computed observables. Now, Knockout's documentation gives us a pretty good first explanation here, introducing the concept of computed observables. In this case, they're saying, if we have a first name and a last name, both observables, Bob Smith, how do we get the full name? Well, rather than putting the joining logic, Bob plus space plus Smith, everywhere, all over the place, instead we can define a computed observable. Computed observables are awesome, and they're pretty simple to implement in Knockout. All you have to do is run ko.computed, passing in the function that computes what you want, and an optional suggested argument for the thing that maps to the this keyword inside that function. Basically, because of the way ko.computed works, when we pass in this for the second argument, that ensures that we can use the this keyword inside the function. And this means that we can use our other observables because we have access to the this that they're on. So again, in summary, this.fullname equals ko.computed, and then a function which simply returns first name added to a space and then added to last name. Now we can use it like any other variable, this.fullname. Pretty cool.